Night has fallen. We live under the cover of darkness. But we are not alone. There's no reason to fear, because Jesus Christ is with us. Let us prepare our hearts for worship. Will those who are able please stand? A trumpet sounds from afar.
Listen, God is calling.
What does the Lord say to us?
Now is the time. Today is the day.
Now is the time to return to God.
Today is the day of our salvation.
Our sins cover us like darkness spread over the mountains. Praise our God of grace and constant compassion.
Thanks be to our Lord.
Let us sing together hymn number 78, Alas and Did My Savior Bleed. Let's pray together. Almighty God, Our hearts are laid bare before you, Lord. You see us as no one else does. You see past the masks that we wear. O God, we come to worship you, not with empty words and meaningless acts of piety, but with lonely, aching spirits. We long for the days of joy and gladness that we have known with you. Fold back the darkness that surrounds us. Show us your mercy. Cover us with your grace. We return our whole hearts to you this day as we pray together humbly in the name of Jesus. Amen. You may be seated. Let's prepare our hearts to hear God's word by singing together the second verse of Open My Eyes That I May See. Our scripture lesson comes from the book of Isaiah, chapter 58. Shout out, do not hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Announce to my people their rebellion, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yet day after day they seek me and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that practiced righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgments. They delight to draw near to God. Why do we fast, but you do not see? Why humble ourselves, but you do not notice? Look, you serve your own interest on your fast day and oppress all your workers. Look, you fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I choose a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I choose, to loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own kin? Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help and he will say, here I am. If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom shall be like the noonday. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places and make your bones strong. And you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruins shall be rebuilt. You shall raise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Today is the beginning of the season of Lent. It's a 40-day period of reflection. The word Lent means to fast, and we certainly talk a lot about fasting during Lent, giving something up, something that we like. We might talk about fasting from chocolate or beer or meat or maybe even TV or the internet or Facebook, something that we like to do. And showing discipline is a good thing. It's a good thing for us to give up something that we like to do and show that kind of discipline. But simply giving things up is not complete. The passage in Isaiah states that God wasn't satisfied with the fasting that the people did. And the reason he wasn't satisfied was that he didn't simply want them to give things up. He didn't simply want them to go through the rituals of fasting. But he wanted them to do something as well. The kind of fast that he was talking about was not just a fast of taking something away, but yet a doing something that you didn't do before. To complete the spiritual discipline of fasting, one must add something in place of the thing that one gives up. And that thing is to help us to become closer to God. If you give up something that you like to eat or drink, and for many of us, that by in and of itself is difficult to do. But if you do that, then pledge to take the money that you would have spent on those items and give that to the poor. Give that to some good cause. If you give up something that takes up time in your day, then devote that time to prayer, studying the Bible, or doing something for someone else. Maybe you could visit a soup kitchen and help to serve there. Or maybe you could visit somebody in a nursing home or send cards, call someone who's sick. Don't just take something away from your life, but add something to give glory to God. Don't just fast from something and say, woe is me, look at me, I'm fasting. But delve into life in its fullest, giving of yourself to those who are in need. The purpose of Lent is not simply to give up those things we do that might not be fruitful. Because that's easy. That's easy. But it's to do things that God would want us to do instead. Always, Lent is a time to take stock of our lives. It's always a time for us to reflect on the way that we live our lives. Isaiah 58 talks about what is the kind of fast that God would really want. Is it simply going through the religious rituals, or is there more to that life that God would lead us to? Are there things that we are doing that hurt God or ourselves or others? Are there things that we are not doing that we know God is wanting us to do? During these 40 days of Lent, it's a time of reflection, but also repentance. Repentance means to turn around, to go the other way, turning away from those things that keep us from living a full life of faith and turning toward those things that bring us closer to God. It's then that we reflect God's glory and shine with the light of Christ in the world. It is then that light comes into the darkness, a light that casts all the darkness away. It is then that we truly appreciate the forgiveness that we've received and live a life of gratitude to God for what he has done for us. Amen and amen. I now invite you to the observant of the Lenten discipline. The Apostle Paul writes, "We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, God made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. Ash is a traditional sign of repentance, contrition, and sin. Tonight, the mark of the cross is made on your foreheads in ash, a sign of our desire to be reconciled with God. Come before God. Come before God. Come before God.
We come facing our own death.
Come before God.
We come ready to receive God's forgiveness and new life.
We're going to sing our prayer of confession. It's hymn number 195, Have Mercy on Us, Living Lord. Come to the table of the Lord because we sin. We come to the table of the Lord to receive forgiveness. We come to the table of the Lord to become one with Jesus Christ, to know his love, and to know that he has brought us into his family so that we might invite others in as well. We come to the table of the Lord broken. We are not perfect people, but God loves broken people, and God came for broken people, and he invites you now to eat and to drink with him and receive wholeness in Jesus Christ. Let us pray together. Dear Lord, we thank you that you love us with that everlasting love, that you've loved us even when we have strayed, that you loved the people of Israel even when they worshiped other gods, that you provided a way of forgiveness for them, that you loved the people who followed Christ and yet still remained in their sin because they didn't know any better. And yet you shone your light on them, showing them the error of their ways and offering them that forgiveness, knowing that you are there with them. That you love us so much that you have baptized us in water, causing us to experience your death and then your resurrection to new life. That you have offered us forgiveness of our sins. Help us to remember our sinful state so that we can appreciate your grace and mercy. Lord, we come to you now empty. Fill us, Lord, with these gifts from the field and from the vine. Fill us now with your Spirit so that we might become one with you. Fill us so that we are filled to overflowing so that your love might spread to this lost and broken world. We pray all these things in the name of your Son, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, On the night that he was betrayed, Jesus was with his disciples, his friends, and he took bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, This is my body, which has been broken for you. Eat this in remembrance of me. And after they had eaten, Jesus took the cup, and he said, This cup is the new covenant of salvation poured out in my blood for the sins of many. Drink this in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we proclaim Christ's death, yes, but also his resurrection and ascension until he comes back again. These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. We will be taking communion by intinction, and we will also be doing the ritual of the ashes. And so what I'll do is we'll have our servers come forward. I'll put two servers on this side. There's one. I'm going to have you two be back here. As you come forward, if you wish to receive ashes, I will give you the ashes, and then you can go and have experience forgiveness. Our sin makes us dirty. It makes us weep. When people in Israel experienced grief, they put on sackcloth and sat in ashes and remembered their grief. And we do that as well. In taking communion, we experience forgiveness and new life in Christ. Please come and receive Christ's blessing. Thank you. We're now going to sing together the traditional version of Be Thou My Vision, so there's one extra verse that rather than the verses that are in the hymnal. You'll know Be Thou My Vision, though, when you hear it. It's not the words that are there. It's sort of a mixed mash there. So. Receive the charge. Go from this sacred space and know that God goes before you. From before your birth and long after your death, you are in a constant and real relationship with your loving, forgiving, encouraging God. Live as children of the light. And now what I would like to have us do is to stand and to make a circle. So find the people who are around you. Maybe come this way a little. Include me, please. That's okay. It's new and different. We have one coming up. And we're including you all in absentia up there, okay? The grace of Christ attend you. The love of God surround you. The Holy Spirit keep you, that you may live in faith, abound in hope, and grow in love, both now and forevermore. Amen. I think...